Separate power plants versus long power cables. Well, this is a good question, and it comes to us from Eli in Israel. And Eli writes, "Hi, Paul. I enjoy your videos and I learn a lot." Why, thank you, sir. I appreciate you watching. "In many answers, you said to use long balanced interconnects and short speaker cables. And you also said to keep the space between the speakers free." Yep. "So let's say I bought mono blocks, which I placed near the speakers, and then put the preamp and the sources along the sidewall. Well, now what do I do? Do I buy one big power plant and run at least one every long power cable for every one, or two or three smaller power plants with short power cables? Which is best and why?" Well, I'll show you what I do. Of course, I get a pretty good deal on power plants, and they are expensive. You can see in my setup, these are the BHK monoblocks. So he is a 300 watt per, single, monoblock. And then I have a separate P20 power plant dedicated to this monoblock. Now, granted, that's a lot of frickin' money, but that's the best way to do it. So one power plant, one amplifier. If I were not able to get such a good deal on power plants, I would have one power plant on each of the, one to feed both of those BHK monoblocks. So I would get one power plant, a P15 maybe, a P20 if you can afford it, and run the monoblocks off that one power plant, and then have a separate power plant, a smaller one, for the source equipment, which is along the sidewall. You can also do it with one power plant and long power cables, but since the quality performance is so dependent on a bunch of factors, and among those, the quality of the power cable itself. I know. People are gonna go, ah! But it's true. And power cables make a big difference. So I prefer short power cables. And if you have to have a long one, use it to feed a power plant. Because the power plant, these are, for those of you that don't know, power plants are AC regenerators. They take the power, the AC, out of the wall. It's a big power amp, and it comes in here, gets converted in the power supply to DC, battery voltage essentially, and then regenerates new electricity, perfect sine waves that don't have any distortion. But most important on the power plant is not so much the distortion, even though it doesn't have any, it's the impedance. Because a power plant is a voltage regulator, it's a dynamic instantaneous voltage regulator that no matter how much dynamic demand you place on the power, it just stays rock solid. Where out of the wall, it's moving up and down. As you can actually see the music on the power. If you put an oscilloscope on the AC power and you play a power amp and you cut out that 60 hertz, you can actually see voltage modulate to the music. Well, with a power plant, you can't do that. And that's at super low output impedance. That really helps the sound quality of what we have. So my best advice, if you're going to go monoblocks, take my advice with long interconnects. Have a power plant at this end behind the speakers and another one for the source equipment along the sidewall. All right. Thanks for the question. I'll talk to you tomorrow.